Hello friends, this is Yogesh Murumkar. In this video, we are going to see different MongoDB operations. So we are going to talk about this particular statement actually. Execute at least 10 queries on any suitable MongoDB database and then demonstrate this where queries, skip, limit and database commands. So I am already connected to MongoDB database. If I type DB, you can check it's my DB. If I type show DBS, it will show me all the databases. So what we are going to do here is we are going to talk about where queries first. So let us create a collection name as TAB. So just copy that particular thing and paste it here. Let me make this D as lowercase. So DB stands for database. So db.tab.insert. Insert is the command. Now I want to insert three documents inside the TAB collection. So I'm going to insert the first document. The syntax should be correct. There should be curly bracket for every document. So it is student ID, then semester, and then English, Maths and Science. These are the subjects. So this is the first document in which we have these keys and these values. Now for the second document, again you will have to write it correctly. It should be in curly braces. So let me paste it here on Mongo shell. So this is your second document. It is also having student ID, semester English, maths and science as keys. And then the last and the third document. So we have total three documents with student ID stu002, stu001 and stu003. So let us complete the curly brace and square brace and parenthesis. And if I type enter, if I press enter, then you can see these results are written. So three documents are inserted inside the collection TB. So db.tab.find.pretty. If I do it, you will see all those three documents. Underscore ID, that is object ID, is created by MongoDB itself, that we have already seen and we have already talked about it in previous videos related to MongoDB. And here you can see these are the different fields. Now what we are going to do is how we are going to learn how to use where queries or where clause. So what I want is I want grade of English and math, English and science as same grade. So here you can look, here the grade is for English it is A plus and science A, here A plus, here A. So wherever the grade of English and science are same, I want to display only those documents. So let us copy this particular query and paste it onto Mongo shell. So here we are using where keyword and this dot English equal to this dot science. So this is actually a keyword and that can be obj also. Obj stands for object. So we are using this dot English equal to this dot science. This is a keyword. So why we are using it? Because we want to make sure that those two fields should have equal values. So the JavaScript expression or function that can be referred to as th as this or obj object. So it is all about that. That's why I said it's a keyword. So if I type this particular query and enter, you can see there are two documents as output, because for these two documents we have grade for English and science as same. So in first document it's A and in second document it's A plus. So it is because of this where condition. So this is how you can use conditions in MongoDB by using where. So if you want to run, if you want to get the same answer, you can run these two queries also. So these are going to give you the same answer. Next we are going to move the cursors. So what is cursor actually? Cursor by default points to the first document in any collection. So cursor is just a pointer. It moves to the first document and then second and then third. So you can see here and then you can read these things also. It is given here only what is cursor and how it works actually. So it is like a pointer. It moves to the first record or document, then second and then third. So the cursor will start at the first record in the collection and then it will iterate through that whole collection. So document 1, 2, 3, this is what is shown here. Okay, so what I am going to do is I am going to create a collection name as employee, and then I am going to insert four documents into that collection, and then I will show you how cursor works or how you can control that particular cursor, how you can make it to point to a particular document in a collection. So let us first create the employee collection with the same documents which are given in that particular PDF. One more point, whatever the PDF I am going to use here and whatever the text file again I will use in this particular session, so you will find out all those files below this video in the description. You can download them and you can use them after watching this video. Okay, so db.employee.insert, so we have two keys here, employee ID, employee name. So in the first document the employee ID is 1, so put it 1, then put comma, and then the next key is employee name. So the employee name value of that is Smith. So you should follow all the syntax. That particular key should always be in double quotes, and if the value is also character, then you should put the value in double quotes also. So this is the first document with employee ID 1 and employee name as Smith. Now let us go for the second document in our employee collection. So in second document again there are two keys, employee ID and employee name. So the employee ID value of this key is 2 and employee name for the second document is Mohan. So you can look it in the document. We are going to create the same collection which is given in our PDF document, so that it will be easy for us to understand further things. So we have typed these two documents in our employee collection. There are two more documents we need to type, because we are going to need four documents in employee collection. So the next one is employee ID 3 and another field, employee name is Joe. So the person, the employee with ID 3 is having employee name as Joe. And one more document I am going to insert in this employee collection. So it is also, you can see it in the PDF provided. So with employee ID 4 and name as L. So fourth and the last document is having employee ID as 4 and employee name as L. So you can check it here. Yeah, this one, ALE. This is the name of the person. So I am also just typing the same names and same IDs whichever given in that particular PDF document. So this is the collection. This is how you can create employee collection. If I press enter, you can see those four documents are inserted into employee collection. And if I want to check it, I can check it with this find command. So these are the four documents you can see: employee ID 1, 2, 3, 4 and employee names respectively. What I will do is, to show how cursor works, what we will do, we will create a variable with my employee name which will store the value of cursor. That means to which particular document the cursor is pointing out. So what I am giving is, I am giving a condition that employee ID should be greater than 2. That means it should point to the third document. So that my employee variable should be pointing to the third document in employee collection. Because the condition is employee ID $GT means greater than 2. So it means that the cursor is currently pointing to document 3, because the condition was greater than 2. Now how to check that? For that, what I will do is, I will run this particular while loop. So while my employee dot has next, that means if there is a next document, then what we are going to do is, we are going to print them. So my employee is the name of my cursor, and then print. So instead of my cursor, the name of my cursor which I have created is my employee. So I will have to type to JSON and then my employee dot next. So if there is a next document, if there is a next document in the collection after the document to which cursor is pointing, then it is going to display that particular document. So see, greater than 2, that means it was pointing to 3. That's why it has printed the document with employee ID 3 and 4. You are getting? So this is how cursor works. the explanation of this particular thing is given, and this is the same output which you got in our case for employee collection by using cursors. The next part is how MongoDB query modification can be done using limit and sort. That's what we want to discuss here. So for limit, we are going to fire this particular query on the same document. So limit is nothing but it is going to limit the number of documents to be displayed. So you just use the function called as limit. So here we are using limit as 2, so it is going to display two documents. So one, employee ID 1 and employee ID 2, because we have written limit as 2 in our query. You can see it. So this is how you can use this limit function for querying the different collections in MongoDB. So again, the explanation is given in this PDF. You can read it later on. Now the next is we want to know how sorting works. So what I have done is I have created one collection called as orders collection. I am going to add these documents in orders collection. I have already created orders collection. So this is the code. I have just copied that code into this text file, because copying that from PDF, it was giving me errors. So I have copied it and I have put the comma. You will also have to check before running that particular command. So paste it here and see, these documents are inserted in orders collection. If I want to check what are the documents in my orders collection, so these documents will be added to previous documents. So here you can check, these are the total number of documents I am having in my orders collection. Now what I will do is I will show you how to use sort on orders collection. So you can sort all those documents depending on any field. So we are going to sort these documents depending on the basis of, for example, amount field. If I want to sort them, you can do that either in ascending or descending order. So if I type this command db.orders.find, so it is going to show all those documents in the ascending order by default. But what if I want in descending order of amount? So you just put amount minus 1 and run this command. You will see all those documents in the descending order of amount. So here you can check, amount 50 is first, and then amount 30, and then amount 20, and then 15, 10, and 10. So this is how you can use sorting in case of MongoDB. Sorry. And the next part is cursor.skip. So for this, what you can do is, I have provided one text file to you, so you can refer that text file for these cursors and skips. So what I have done in this file is, I have created a collection named as student data. So you can find out that text file in your in the description below this video. You can download that. So this is the student data collection I have created. If you want to check what are all the documents which are present in student data, so these are the documents in student data, three documents with student ID 2002, 2003 and 2004. Now we are going to see how to use the operations like skip on that particular student data. So for example, db.studentdata.find student ID greater than 2002. So this particular query is going to give me the student IDs which are greater than 2002. That means it is going to show me two documents as the output. This one, 2003 and 2004. Student ID 2003 and student ID 2004. Because we have given a condition. Now what we can do is, so in our output total we got two documents, right? So we will see how to use that limit and skip now. So though this particular condition, that is greater than 2002, student ID greater than 2002, it was satisfied by two documents. That's why I got two documents as output in my previous query. But what if I want only one document? How to do that? So you can use limit for that. So I am going to run the same query, but one function added to it as limit 1. So out of those 2003 and 2004, it is going to show me the first document, that is 2003, student ID 2003, because I have put limit 1. So by default, limit 1 is going to give the first document which is going to satisfy the condition. So here you can find out only one document which satisfies that condition, because we have put limit as 1. Now next, how to do skip operation. For example, I want to skip some documents and I want to directly move to the required document. So how to do that? So you can use a function called as skip, or a method called as skip. So again the same query, if I run So this query we have already run. It is going to show me two documents. You can check. If you run it with limit, it is going with the first document only. But what if I want the second document, which is also satisfying the condition that is greater than 2002? I don't want to see the first document. I want to see the second document only. So what I can do is I can skip the first and directly move the second document. So in this case, it is going to show me the document with student ID as 2004 and not 2003, because what, limit is one and skip one. So out of those two documents, it is going to show the second document. So this is how limit and skip can work. So that is all, friends. You can find out the PDF and the text document in the description below this video. You can download all those documents. So this is all about where queries, cursors and database commands. So that's it. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching this one. If you have any comments, please feel free to write down your comments.